wait for me when I am gone. Duty calls and I must go. For this great battle was I born, when a country's friend has turned the foe. Much has happened in recent times gone by. Blinkered vision blinds our leaders' eyes. They fail to heed the army's desperate cry. Disabled minds prefer to hear our neighbor's lies. To understand our army's basic need, our leaders do not even seem to try to do what has been our basic creed, and not to question how, or when, or why. This brigade is tasked to face first blow. We fight with old and antiquated arms. We're up against a far superior foe, and ground dictated by their forceful terms. This battleground in which we now are placed, below the enemy's dominating ground, malignant Chinese forces what we face, with all advantage in their favor found. Wars only start when leaders fail, when armies allow themselves to lose their strength, when governance permits itself to become frail and fails to execute the role for which it's meant. Desperate state, there is no way that we can save the day. Leaders far away decide our fate, ignorant of the need for better ways to further complicate the game. The enemy continues to call the shots, and to our everlasting shame, we have no game, no plan, no plot. Daily we see the Chinese army grow. They now have massed on Upper Tagla Hills. We're badly placed in positions down below. No mines, no guns, no winter clothing still. The hand of death has announced her presence in skies no longer blue, and all we do is wait with bated breath for death to strike across the Namkachu. When we have gone, it's only this we ask: a chance to snatch fair victory from the jaws of death. Give our sons a means to do their task in defending India's freedom with every mortal breath. When we have gone, it's only this we ask: a chance to snatch fair victory from the jaws of death. To give our sons a means to do their task in defending India's freedom with every mortal breath.